Ready? Okay. All one, two, all one, two, three.
Good evening. We are happy to see you this evening. We are Charlie Three Valves and the Weird Seven, or also the New Orleans Jazz Style class. We are not going to play, not only going to play some old time New Orleans jazz, but some old show tunes as well. Let's get started. The first song was Tin Roof Blues. It's one of our favorites. It's become our theme song. This song was a jazz composition written by the New Orleans Rhythm Kings and was first recorded in 1923. Louis Armstrong and the All-Stars recorded the song for Columbia Records in 1924, and the sheet music cover was an illustration of the Tin Roof Cafe, Dance Hall, and Washington Avenue in New Orleans. Our next number. Next number is Down by the Riverside. It's an African-American spiritual. Its roots date back to before the Civil War. It was first published in 1918. The song was first recorded by the Fisk University Jubilee Quartet in 1920. With this song, I'd like to introduce our fabulous vocalist, Jessi Hyde.
Two, three, four.
was Down by the Riverside, and our next song is called Panama, not the Van Halen song. But this Panama was written by William H. Tyers, who conducted an orchestra at the Strand Roof Garden in New York. In 1919, Tyers was the assistant director of Will Marion Cook's New York Syncopated Orchestra, which toured England and played for King George V.
Thank you.
Our next song is called American Patrol, and it's a popular march written by Frank White Meacham in 1885. It incorporates both original musical themes by Meacham and melodies from American patriotic songs of the era, such as Columbia, the Gem of the Ocean, and Yankee Doodle. It was originally written for piano, but was then arranged for wind band and published by Carl Fischer in 1891. Glenn Miller's orchestra popularized the song during World War II with a swing version arranged by Jerry Gray in 1942. So enjoy American Patrol.
Thank you.
Our next song, How High the Moon, is a jazz standard with lyrics by Nancy Hamilton and music by Morgan Lewis. It was first featured in the 1940 Broadway review, Two for the Show. In Two for the Show, this was a rare serious moment in an otherwise humorous venue. So here is How High the Moon. Night would shine if you would come to me soon. Until you will, how still my heart, how high the moon. Okay, so this next song is called My Funny Valentine, and it is a show tune from the 1937 Rodgers and Hart coming-of-age musical Babes in Arms. The song became a popular jazz standard, appearing on over 1,300 albums performed by over 600 artists. With that number of people wanting to record it, it is amazing that when the song first hit the charts in 1945, it only appeared for 1 week at number 16. So here's My Funny Valentine. figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak when you open it to speak? Are you smart? But don't change a hair for me. Not if you care for me. Stay, little Valentine. Stay. Each day is Valentine's Day. Your figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak when you open it to speak? Are you smart? But don't change a hair for me. Not if you care for me. Stay, little Valentine. Stay. Each day is Valentine's Day.
So first I'd like to mention that somehow we missed our guitarist, John Musto. So he's not on the program, but John has been a part of this like since we started doing this Charlie 3 valve. So John, and then I wanna say thank you to Chuck for putting these notes together. I've been a little bit tied up lately, so I really appreciate Mr. 3 Valves, who's kicking us off on all of our songs also. Also, thank you to Michael Hillstrom and to Paige Lush and to Daniela Roderick, who's our chair or the humanities director here. And then also thank you to Paul Bayer, who does all of the sound for us here today. Thank you, Paul. I just wanted to mention also in the back of your programs, bring your attention to the fact that we have upcoming concerts. On Saturday, there's a French horn concert at 7 o'clock right here. And on Sunday, the MCC Concert Band has a concert at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. It's at Woodstock High School. That's the old high school, not Woodstock North, Woodstock High School, again at 3 o'clock on Sunday. And then a week from tomorrow, the MCC Choir has a concert, and their concert will be here in this location also. And then on Sunday, May 7th, at 7 o'clock, also in here, we will have the student recital, And I know several of the students here and some other students will be doing their recital pieces here on that day. So all of those are good opportunities. If you're looking for music appreciation credits and looking for something to go to, you can come to any of those. Also on April 30th is the Crystal Lake Community Band at the Holiday Inn in Crystal Lake at 4 o'clock. I want to thank everybody for coming today. And for our last song for the evening, we are doing Alabama Jubilee. It was a song written by George L. Cobb with words by Jack Yellen. First known recording was that of comedians Collins and Harlan in 1915. A 1981 instrumental version by Roy Clark won a Grammy Award for Best Country Instrumental Performance. So here's Alabama Jubilee.
One, two, one, two.